Thank you. Thank you, Steve. Hi, guys. I'm just here, as Steve said, just to sort of not to try and impress anyone with some of the things that I've done, but just to try and impress upon you. I'm hoping that you can look at this and you can think, oh, my God, if this guy can achieve one or two fairly good things, then so can I. I left school. I didn't know what the hell they were talking about in school, algebra and sort of A equals C square and all of the rest of the sort of stuff. It was just alien to me. So I left school with very low self-esteem, and I really didn't think I was going to achieve anything in my life. So I wanted to be like my cousin, and I wanted to... what I want to get across to you is about being bold and having big dreams, because you might as well just go out there and go for the dreams that you have, because the last thing that any of us want is to sort of be at 80 or 90 years old and think to myself, I didn't achieve my dreams. My cousin was my biggest inspiration. This is Windsor Davis. I told my sergeant major that I wanted to be a commando like my cousin. And that's the sort of look he gave me. I failed my basic army fitness test. I was voted the fattest person in the troop. And then basically I went on to... I passed the commando course after failing several times. This is a run I did in the Sahara Desert. And this was an incredible thing as well, because I kind of thought to myself that the people in the local paper were just so far beyond what I could ever achieve. I could never be like that. And then sort of ended up getting into the national papers. Did a run in America, a 1,620-mile run in America. That was my biggest fear was bears, because the Americans were like, be careful, man. The bears are coming down from the hills. And I was like, oh, my God, this is crazy stuff. And I ran against a guy in the Sahara Desert. It was a 50-mile run, and I ended up beating him. And I went on, fortunately, to break a treadmill world record. This was surreal as well, because you look at people in the media and you think to yourself, they are so far above me, I just couldn't relate to someone. And then when you're on the same page as someone like Catherine Zeta-Jones or a Shane Williams, it was just really, really bizarre, because I'm just like a kid from Harford West, a small town in southwest Wales. Thus setting up a running event. And this is my greatest joy, is really setting up charity events. There was fortunate enough to get some of the highest sports achievers in Pembrokeshire involved. My biggest inspiration there, really, Anthony Hopkins. I didn't have much self-confidence when I was younger, and I listened to an interview on him, and he said, risk death, risk destruction, risk being a fool, risk criticism, and just go for it. And that's my biggest running inspiration. There's a guy called Terry Fox. He ran 3,339 miles across Canada. He raised a dollar for each Canadian, which was $24 million. And now it's gone on to raise over $600 million. The reason I put this in, this is my four-year-old son, Mr. Happy. There's a story about surrounding yourself with happy people. And this is one of the things. If you end up being around negative, cynical people, you will end up sort of negative and cynical yourself. Richard Branson, another tremendous inspiration. Christian Bale, he's from the same sort of town as me in Haverford West. And that's another thing. I thought to myself, I couldn't be successful because I was from a small town. Obviously, he's a lot more successful than I am. And Risa Fans, again, from a small town. And you kind of think to yourself, these people, the successful people in life, they're from New York or they're from London, and you can just come out of anywhere. It doesn't matter what color your skin is, what background you've got. I set up a superhero day, which was on Christian Bale's birthday, which is, we're now expanding it all around the UK, and it's to raise money for children in hospital. Talk about putting yourself out there. I've been cycling for about 5 minutes, and the guy on the far left with his Bradley Wiggins with his arm round is my new sort of cycling coach for a run I'm doing across America. This is my big goal now, which is I'm running, cycling and walking 7 times across America for 7 charities over 7 years. Our goal is to raise $7 million. We're working with Edward Norton's CrowdRise team. This is what I sort of want to end up with as well, is about sort of going for your, overcoming your fears. This is, Leon is my son, and he's the greatest joy in my life. And when I first looked at his mum, I thought to myself, this girl is so far out of my league. Don't ask her. You shouldn't ask her out. And I ended up asking her out. And I think sometimes the greatest thing that's in your life come from the biggest risks that you take. So I'd like to just sort of close off by here by saying, just be bold, go for it, risk, and live your dreams. Thank you so much, guys. Thank you.
Give it up. I'll play Mark.